I'm Pete Donaldson, backstage at V Festival on what can only be described as a boatload of hair, basically. And look who's with me, Miss Clare Maguire.
Hello.
How are you doing, my dear?
I'm very good, thank you. How are
You're
you?
You're looking resplendent, not wearing jean shorts like every other lady on site.
I know, I noticed
my
that. I was like, obviously in heat. The thing is, jean shorts at the moment, yeah. But I'm not. I'm not wearing this on stage, though.
No. Oh, have you got another? Have you got another outfit sorted?
Yeah.
What are we talking?
We're talking
catsuit.
Well, it's like
leotard.
A really fitted kind of jacket done by this girl called Vicky, and she's incredible, and she's made it herself. And then some Kurt Geiger massive shoes.
Good old Vicky and Kurt Geiger. Good stuff. Your debut album, Light and Dark. Are you pleased with the reaction?
Yeah, I'm really pleased, actually. Yeah, it's been really, really good. I've been very busy, and I've been able to tour with people like Plan B and Script and Hurts, which has been incredible for me. And making a new album at the moment, through all that experience, I guess, you know, gives you a lot. So, yeah,
you putting a bit of rapping on it, dealing with Plan B?
Yeah, I thought I'd try a little bit, you know, Nicki Minaj, why not?
What was it like touring with Plan B?
Because he's quite,
amazing. He's got a huge sort of... backing band, doesn't he?
Yeah. I'm telling you, like, that was probably the most incredible experience I've done so far. He as a person is really inspiring, and his show is just incredible. I was just talking about it actually to somebody. I was just like, it's amazing that it's really soul-y. And then at the very end, like the encore, it just goes proper hard. It's like really dubstep and everything. It's amazing.
Because you started writing music when you were at seven, did I read? What did you write about back then? Polly Pocket?
I was really dark, actually. I was writing really dark stuff. And I remember singing it to my mom and her just being like, you're right, Claire. Is everything
okay? Do I need to call someone?
Fine. Just a bit weird.
What were your sort of influences back then, were you?
I was obsessed kind of with Johnny Cash, actually. And
that's going to make your music dark,
isn't it? Yeah, so that's kind of probably why. And then a lot of like, kind of Irish folk music, the Pogues and all that, and then Frank Sinatra and kind of classic stuff. I always like classic music, James Brown.
Oh, good
kind
stuff.
Of thing.
Are you thinking of donning a cape at any point during your performances?
Yeah,
that'd be pretty
definitely.
Good.
Why
it?
Not?
I also read that your first bit of sort of music industry hobnobbing was, of course, Jay-Z. Downing shots with Jay-Z in a bar or something.
Yeah, it's quite embarrassing.
Do you sort of take that sort of thing in your stride or?
No, definitely not. I was like, really, really nervous. I think so. I got a little bit drunk before he came, very nervous. And then just when he did come in, and I was eating a burger at the time, and it just looked really embarrassing and like proper Birmingham girl. Like, and I was just like, hi, you're right. And then he had all these, he gave everybody a shot, and then I ended up having about six or something and just being really embarrassing. And I'd prefer not to talk about that. No, it was good.
But I mean, I guess you've just exploded from that first meeting. What has been your highlight so far this year, for example? Was it touring with Plan B or just the festivals?
I think so. Oh, playing Glastonbury was amazing. Yeah. V Festival today, which I'm really excited about. Canberra Festival. Just the festivals and the live shows are the best bit, I think.
Yeah.
Definitely, without a doubt. Cause
is that what you were sort of born to do to a certain extent? Are you a recording artist or rather a live performer? Are you...
I think a little bit of both. I think especially with the stuff that I'm writing for my new record now, I'm thinking a lot about live shows.
Yeah.
I think before I was thinking more just being in the studio and
getting out on MySpace or something.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah, just trying to get it out there, I guess. But then I think now, because I've done all this experience just touring, I'm starting to really think about, you know, how it's going to sound.
How would that work
as
live?
A show. Yeah.
So do you have a backing band and stuff? Have you got sort of
people? Yeah, they're really, really good actually. Yeah, they're amazing. I'm really happy with my band at the moment. So check it out. I do really like it, and I've got an amazing MD called Kojo, and he's incredible, and just the sounds he can get, just through, it sounds very different to the record actually.
Yeah
It's really good.
Are you looking forward to any other acts playing today? Are you gonna
I really want to see Registry 2, but he's playing just before me, so I'm going to try and watch it and then run back and get changed really quickly. Jesse J I want to see, Arctic Monkeys, who I'm obsessed by, Plan B, Chasing Status, KEB. A really good.
You've got a busy
Maverick
day then,
Sabre.
Haven't you?
Yeah, I love Maverick Sabre.
Yeah,
he's incredible.
Speaking of Chasing Status, they remixed one of your tracks.
Yeah, they did.
How was that? Have you met the guys before? Did you just sort of post the master tapes to them and they just did their business? And
well, I had never met them, but I had a track that I did with a guy called Richard X, and they heard it and they just wanted to use it.
Yeah.
And it's really good. It's kind of very different to the rest of their record. It's really down.
Yeah.
Beat. And I played with them actually, and they wanted me to kind of like stand in the middle of the stage and just stand there and sing it. And when I did, like, because the noise was so loud, like the mic was just shaking forward and forward and forward, and I almost fell off the stage basically. To be playing with them, they're amazing.
Good stuff. Well, what are you going to be doing the rest of the year? Are you sort of just putting out this new album?
Yeah, writing this new record. I think filming a little bit in the studio and just doing the record making, really, and a few live bits and pieces here and there.
Good stuff. Yeah. Clare Maguire, thank you very much.
You.
Absolute Radio. Backstage at V.